Hello everybody, assalamu alaikum. I hope it's a wonderful day for you. I'm going to talk about a very important topic, and that is, are women in India liberated or subjugated? And this is a topic which has to be dealt with a lot of sophistication, and it has to be spoken in a candid way, so that people really understand what the reality is. So we have a wonderful panelist here with us. We have Dr. Harmindar Singh, the editor of Khalsa, and also he's from the Khalsa Public School. And we have Sister Anupama from Anubandha, the organization called Anubandha. She's into a lot of child's welfare activities, as well as she talks for the women's rights and many other issues. So thanks for being at the studio here. We're going to be talking about the subject in an open way. Are the women in India liberated or subjugated? If they are liberated, why do you say they are liberated? And if they are subjugated, why do you say they are subjugated? That's the topic. So what makes a person liberated and what makes a person subjugated? And in today's context, we see, you know, women are being victimized, being abused in various levels. You find many cases where the case of Nirbhaya, where a lady was raped in the capital city of India, in Delhi, and she was killed, and over a period of time she died. And many such cases, whenever there's some riots happening in India, you find the women being raped, and they're showing all the anger against the community, against the woman, and this is a sign of degrading any community. This we have come across. And we also find women, children, or child, you know, women, we're talking about girls, not given scope for education. And when they upgrade themselves to become, adults, and they're not given enough encouragement to do any professional courses. And all these things we find in our country, India. Right from the beginning of female feticide and infanticide and child abuse, and then not letting her to pursue her career, we find a lot of inconsistency in saying that we are the people who revere the women, and at the same time we are not encouraging the women to achieve great honor and status in our community. Do we agree to this or don't we agree to this? This is what we are going to debate on. Let me first put forward the question to Doctor. Doctor, what do you say about the Indian psychology today? Among the youths, among the current contemporary leaders, what do we actually think about women?
If we say about the India, especially for the young generation and also the politician, I think it is a very important topic which is very much related with each and every family and to our nation. The main, we can see in there, we have not given provided proper education to the female children. From here, all the problem has started. If the female child are equally educated, then 90% problem are going to solve. Scanty question about the politician. Politician, they just come and go. They least bother about the nation. They want to develop their own families or own status. And all the problems started here first in the caste. It is related very much to the education. If the child or female, maybe the girl, mother, daughter, whatever, their stage is here. If they're educated, they understand. And furtherly, next more to that, only the woman are main backbone behind the nation to develop this country. Because we get up morning, we see a mother, we see our daughter, we see our wife. Without that, we can say totally incomplete. Even the question raised before the Guru Nanak, or the founder of Sikhism, they ask about the woman's status on those days, about 500 years ago. The Guru Nanak said, "So kyo manda aakhi hai, jit jame razaan." The woman who given birth to a king, to strength, how can be impure? She cannot be. Because the mother, she gave birth to Rama, she gave birth to Krishna, she gave birth to Nanak, She even Muhammad Saab in the Jesus Christ too. Now I'll talk about my own faith. Where the Guru Nanak had said such things, even he spoke more about that, the liberation, freedom, about the woman. But in my religion, my faith also, still, they doesn't allow women to make perform in the Golden Temple or other historical places.
Mm-hmm.
They will never speak openly.
Okay.
No. But indirectly, in their mind,
mm-hmm.
the same thing is stamped. Mm-hmm. And they say, they are unable to say openly, she's impure.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying straightforward. Because if they say openly, the people will against them.
Mm-hmm.
They will fight with them. So indirectly, they are doing same thing what is going on there. Because lacking of knowledge.
It's a very interesting point he stressed upon. That women are not treated equally in religious get-togethers. It's a very important point.
The first point is our home, family. Which also we can say our own family is a temple. Own family is a gurdwara. Own family is a masjid. Own family is a church. So when we don't have the basic respect or status at our home, no question she will get the same place, the temple, church, mosque or gurdwaras. Further remaining there, maybe related to economics. This also with the education. Meaning the overall development for thinking, with the social, for status, stigma, whatever there, it is related with the education. Until we are not making proper education for the woman, our country or our faith, or we cannot develop.
Fine. We will continue further. The real highlight of his presentation was that until we educate the women folks, you cannot expect any great change in the society. Now, aren't women educated enough today? We also find, on an extreme, women are educated with a lot of things. Women have the access for knowledge. Women are having through the internet and through the television also, a lot of things they are learning. And they feel they are so liberated. But at the end of the day, what is bringing to the society? With the education, are we really using the education in the right perspective? Or is it not been applied in the right sense, and are we misusing that education? Why am I saying this? Even in colleges, we come across a culture today where in the college life, you know, women also, the girls and the women, if I have to say, they also indulge in smoking, they also indulge in discotheque, the culture of, you know, they call it as casual relationship and flirting, and all in the name of liberation. And they say they are the educated people. Now, what do you have to say? Where do we draw the line? What is education? If education is bringing a positive outcome, then it is appreciated. But if education is not bringing that what is intended, then are we able to achieve it through education?
Namaste, Hari Om. I feel, Umar Bhai, if there is a term called liberatedly subjugated.
Okay, it's a new term that we can try to put it in the dictionary.
So I feel, you know, like compared to what we were before, there is a topic about that also. India yesterday, India today, India tomorrow. Compared to what we were before, I feel to a very large extent we are liberated.
Okay.
And we have the entire legal system supporting to women's needs.
Mm-hmm.
And trying to protect them. Somewhere I feel, you know, my own clan, the women clan, are not really being sensible enough to understand what exactly a woman needs.
Okay.
Now, they say, just like you mentioned, and which is a fact also, that they smoke in public, they drink in public, they do whatever a man does, they want to do in the name of equality. I always tell the women folk, don't stoop down to that equality level. I always consider my clan to be a very super kind of, they're much superior than a man, because God has made them like that. No matter how much a man tries or wants to do or whatever, he cannot reproduce.
True.
That is the strength of a woman. So I wouldn't want my clan to degrade themselves in the name of equality and do stuff which is not at all actually respected in the society. At the end of everything, we are Indians. We have our own culture, which is a very strong one. And we follow it and we respect only that. We might be a little or probably more fascinated with the Western culture, but then our roots is Indian and we have some do's and don'ts, and that is how we are going to kind of look at a lady about what she does. Now, liberalization is something about how you think, how liberalized you are. If you feel you are, you know, like oppressed by somebody or the men, I think it is wrong. When you have the entire system coming forward to help you, you need not be oppressed by anybody. Why blame the men? I would say blame yourselves. And like the doctor sir said, education. Many women don't know what the law of this country is, all the amendments which has been made to protect the women's rights or their needs. It is up to the women folk again. You have so many organizations, the so-called feminist, you know, you have all those. I expect them to come forward and educate the women about their strength, what the legal system has made for protecting them.
True.
Instead of, you know, like asking for rights and all that, now even in the parliament, you have a topic saying that 30% reservation for women. It's going to become 50%. For what? Every woman or most of the women go sit in the parliament and not doing anything really what is to be done for the common woman.
Right.
So that is not what we want.
Mm-hmm.
I would always suggest, you know, like any woman for that matter, I mean my clan, any woman has to live with dignity. That is the only thing any woman would want. If she wants money, wants comforts and all, that is none of our business.
Right.
I would expect you still have rural women being raped, being beaten up, being tortured beyond kind of any limits. But nobody is representing them. A wonderful life is when a lady lives a life of dignity, is what I wish to say.
Okay.
And the only strength for her, the tool, the weapon for her is education. She needs to understand whether she does a master's in some stream or not, it's not the topic. She needs to understand what our country's system has in store for her to protect her.
Right.
She needs to be enlightened,
okay,
is what I would
wish to
say.
I want to ask you, in line with this, about how we honoring the women. In India, you know, there is a kind of a culture where women are being worshipped also. See, many goddesses you can find. You find Lakshmi, Saraswati, and many
Durga.
Other Durga, and many other things. And you also find people raising the slogans Bharat Mata Ki Jai,
yes,
because Durga Ma is where it has been depicted.
Correct.
Now, what I'm trying to say, when they have so much of love for womanhood and honor, I want to understand the mindset when they are able to worship goddess in the form of a woman. Now, I want to understand how is that the same populace is indulging in kind of abuse, indulging in disrespecting, dishonoring, and saying that they are impure. And I'm very happy to have seen or heard a doctor openly saying what is happening in his community. And even I cannot say that it is not there in our community. If you say about the Muslim community also, I have to say.
No, we have a Muslim, Sikh and
yeah,
a Hindu here.
We accept what are the
yeah,
issues. See, in many families, we don't find women being encouraged to gain knowledge in
True.
Education. And women are not given freedom to get more spiritual. So that is one section which we need to address amongst our own communities. We cannot say all the followers of all religions are actually 100% following according to the scriptures. There are some people who are actually getting too extreme and too narrow-minded. Why is this kind of mindset there in our country? While we are honoring by our philosophy, we are honoring by our scriptures, why do you think people have gone through this kind of a level?
Probably, I feel, according to me, I feel, I again blame my clan.
Okay.
They have not been assertive about what they want. The problem is, you know, we women are like a liquid. You put us in a glass, we take the form of the glass. You put us in a jar, we take the form of the jar. So we are adapting ourselves to the need of the man.
Okay.
It might be a father, it might be a brother, it might be a husband, or it might be a son.
Mm-hmm.
So it is time for the women. See, as long as you don't do something bad, you can always... Now, there are many people who ask me, you are doing these NGO activities, you are a social activist, you go in front and try to kind of, you know, like confront many unwanted people also. I mean, you are so lucky you have a husband who is letting you do all this.
Right.
I tell them, my husband is not letting me do all this.
Okay.
Because I have never asked for his permission.
Okay.
I always feel if you're doing something good for the society, you don't need anybody's permission.
Okay.
The more you go to the husband, the more you go to the son and ask, seek the permission, that is when you are giving that authority to them.
Okay.
Over you. And that authority is being misused by the man.
Mm-hmm.
So when I discuss with my husband, this is what I'm going to do. Can I do this? Is something what I wouldn't want to use. I would say, yes, I want to do this. I want to help this person. And I'm going to do it this way.
Okay.
Probably I take a feedback from him or okay. some kind of opinions. It's fine for me.
Yeah.
I would definitely want my son, my husband, my father, even Umar Bhai and Dr. Sahab, if you are there to protect me, oh please, I am the most luckiest person to be protected by you.
Right.
But yes, if you want to control me, no. That is a big no for you.
Okay.
So you treat me like yourself. If you want to be controlled
okay.
by somebody,
mm-hmm.
then control somebody. So I feel my clan is, you know, like giving everything on the platter to the men.
Okay.
Okay. I want to work. Okay, fine. You want to work. Do whatever you're supposed to do at home. Then go to work. Is what the, even if the man doesn't tell you, that the expression we understand.
Right.
So somewhere you have to draw a line saying, we are equals.
Okay.
Let's do something together to take our family ahead. So when you leave the reins to the man, he's definitely going to feel superior. He's definitely going to control you.
Right.
So controlling me or controlling a woman should be a strict no.
Okay. Well, we'll take it further. Doctor, what do you have to say about man seen as an authority in the home? Well, Sister Anupama just said that she doesn't want to be controlled. But at the same time, men generally have the tendency of being very protective to the family members, and he becomes the leader of the family. In general terms, if you see, the father becomes the leader of the family. If the father is not there, then the husband becomes the leader of the family. So at that point, somebody has to be the authority and the one taking the responsibility. And how is that one has to manage the family life to ensure that one is able to achieve the freedom of all the members of the family and at the same time giving the right directives to all the members there? Can there be a family without authority and responsibility is my question. So if there is no authority, then how will the family run in a smooth way?
No, you're very right. Authority must and should be there.
Okay.
But her sister said just no. She take advice from husband. And one more question she put here. You can protect me. Why should I protect you? Why you want protection from us? When you're doing the right things, why you need the protection? Huh. The family authority must and should be there. Whatever they want to do, they mutually. Again, question is there. When husband also working, the wife also working. And they having line of control or Lakshman Rekha or limitation of their freedom. Then problem not going to occur there. Yes, when both young person working there, both are educated, they are earning coming, they are planning what to do for future. Want to construct a house, want good, better education for children, and want to do better for the nation.
Right.
So when the planning is there, education is there, they can do it there.
Right.
The question coming, the woman is not required protection from the male.
Mm-hmm.
If they are within their limitation, equality also required. But equality within the limitation again.
Correct.
Now, sir, protection in the sense, we would want that kind of care and concern
yes,
from you.
Yes, that different
thing. I mean, that pampering
care,
thing.
Care, you can
and
say.
And protection again.
Love and affection, you can say.
Unfortunately, probably I always feel God is a man.
Yes.
Because he's made a woman physically weaker than the man. So there, so
you
probably.
Feel, you feel that God has been favorable to one section.
Yeah, so you, I always so feel that, so.
That is what you feel, huh?
You are totally wrong, because you only made the man as a God. The God has not made the male as a God.
Correct.
No. In our holy book, the address to the only Atma, the soul, not the male and female. But here we can hear the woman herself make husband is a God.
Yeah. Now again, what she said is that she said that God has favored one section.
No. No. Why are you physically stronger than us?
Which one?
I always am. No, I'm jealous
you are,
of you.
No. Sita, listen here. You are a Janani. Yeah. You are more stronger than me.
You say that I'm
no,
Janani.
No, I'm not saying
Janani,
that.
Which all that
because
is fine.
It should psychologically, you put in your mind, it is. That's
no,
the most strong. See,
no.
Listen,
physically,
yeah.
I'm
physically
talking about.
Man is
yeah,
strong.
He's strong.
Yeah.
He can do things I can't really. I mean, like nail properly, which he does with finesse. It is
because
he's strong.
He will do exercise. He'll do work. I'll give a small example there. Very small example. Suppose the person is there. He's a failure of business, failure of education. Something happened there. He start drinking, start smoking, going some wrong way. Where the woman, the same way supporting him. Don't do all these things. So who's the stronger?
Mentally, woman
yes.
is definitely stronger. I'm talking about physical. Why God did not make us physically strong also is my question. So that is where
answer.
I'm jealous about you all.
I have an answer. There's a beautiful note I came across which says, the 50% of the people inhabiting on earth are women. And the 50% who are living on earth, they're also brought from the women. So women gets the real the respect and honor, because all the men in the world, they are also coming out of their woman's body only.
Yeah.
So in that way, without women, the world will not exist. You see. So in that case, you should feel the one who is helping in the life to continue on earth. God has chosen women.
Very
here.
True, Bhai. I am very happy to be a woman.
Yeah, yeah.
There is no second.
So where is the favorable
yes,
aspect?
If I were to be physically strong like you all, probably, I mean, like the sky would have been the limit to us. We would not be craving for some people say, I want 50% reservation. I want this. No, we would not be asking you all for that.
What is the necessity 50%? You can come 90%.
Yeah, we would want
to. What is the necessity?
No, then we are very, very, very kind of, you know, like lenient. And we are very considerate beings, the women. So we would say, you take 50,
no,
give me 50.
I want to understand, when people like Indira Gandhi has ruled this country, and we hear even in the history, Jhansi Rani, Sarojini Naidu, and we find they all have accomplished great status. You know, if you say, if one has to be a man to achieve all these things, then the history proves it wrong.
No, I didn't say so.
Yeah.
I never said I had to be a man to achieve all this.
Okay.
I said I would have been very happy if I had the physical
strength
also.
So even without it also, you can achieve
the physical strength. Oh yes, of course,
yes.
If you have women as astronauts, you have women in every walk of life. We say we are no way, inferior to men.
Right.
We have an additional point that, you know, like we are capable of reproducing also a new life.
Okay.
So we are superior, in fact. We are nowhere inferior to you all.
Right. So you have acknowledged that there is no inferiority.
Absolutely not.
So
absolutely.
God has done fair thing to you.
More to woman.
God has been fair to both of us, for both the men and women. We have to acknowledge.
We should always understand that we always complain. We always crib about something or the other. Here I am cribbing that God should have given us physical strength.
So now that you said, you somehow believe that God is a male. But at the same time, we find the Indians worshipping goddess. We find them worshipping Lakshmi, Saraswati and all of them. So what do you have to say about you? Why do you say that you believe in a male God?
No. It's not about that. You know, like it's about... Probably there you have that patriarchal thing going on there above.
Okay, probably.
The man takes the decision.
Okay.
And the man makes the woman physically weak.
Okay.
Maybe.
So it's on conjecture.
Yeah.
It's on conjecture. So I would like to present something here. I think mostly our elderly gentleman, he would also acknowledge this. As far as what he has said, is more or less we find the same concept in the Quran. We believe in God about whom there is no comparison. He's not compared to a male and he's not compared to a female.
Yes.
And he doesn't beget any children and he is not begotten. Meaning he has no parent, he has no children. He is free from all comparison and he is one and only. So thereby we keep this discussion away by saying that he is not a male and he is not a female. And saying that God is unique in his attributes.
No, that was a fun note actually. what I meant.
So
was,
it's nice. It's really appreciated because when you say it as a fun note, so people take it in a funny way.
Yes, yes. You know, like I don't want it. The topic is the Indian woman liberalized is a very vast topic which I cannot or anybody conclude within an hour's time.
Yeah.
It is as vast and it is as confusing here, in fact.
Yeah.
So here I feel the women folk are making it confusing for us by wanting so many unwanted things and saying that this is what we want,
right,
to be treated equal. Whereas still now the rural sites or you have extreme regions,
okay,
where woman does not have a proper clothing on her.
Okay.
So probably this is where we all our organization, the so-called women organizations, have to focus upon, mm-hmm, where every woman of this country, not only women organization, brothers like you all, where the woman of the country, every single woman, lives a life of dignity.
Right.
Square meal per day at least,
mm-hmm,
and a good clothing for her,
right,
and a neat, decent living place is, okay, what a lady needs.
Now, coming to that point. Now, we were just discussing about man being strong physically, man getting a lot of opportunities. Now, if we were to say man, given all the strength, he works and toils every day, earns for the livelihood and also feeds his family, ensures that his women folk are also happy. So in that way, man is also exerting himself to an extent that he is not just living for himself, but he's living for his whole family. That includes his wife, mother, children, which are also from the, they are also from the
true,
women folks.
Very true.
So in that way, I think we are missing out something. Here we are missing out the cultural aspect. Man should not feel that he can live like a vagabond. First and foremost, he has got responsibility of living a life with honor and being a breadwinner and taking care of his family. Secondly, he has to be a person who lives with honor, without any evil practices, which could be dowry, which could be alcoholism, which could be smoking or whatever, which could degenerate his value. What do you have to say about it? Because many of them, they have this tendency to say that, why is that only men are given the freedom to drink and not for the women? I say even the men are not given the freedom. Are men given the freedom to drink alcohol in any of the scriptures, if you have to say that men are allowed and women are not allowed? Aren't we supposed to say both men and women are not allowed? Or are we to say like men are allowed to do certain things and women are not allowed to do certain things?
No, I think the man takes it as a privilege that being a man,
liberty,
he can, yeah, that he can drink or do whatever.
He doesn't want to
who
get
permitted?
Because every bottle of alcohol says drinking or smoking is injurious to health.
Yeah.
It doesn't say it is injurious to a woman's health, to anybody's health.
So that includes,
right,
one man.
That is something wrong.
So what do you have to say, doctor?
No, who encourage? Suppose, I give some other example in society where we are living. The boy will go and do misdeed. The mother says, okay, koi baat nahi, beta hai. No problem. Who encouraging here? When the daughter coming late, no beta, you are a daughter, you will get married, you have to go to some other house. You should not do all these things. So all this, I want to say, the mother, the woman, they should bring, they from home for it to bring, they both are equal.
True. Correct.
If anything happen, whatever there, yes, the father or made it responsibility on for the family. Now, from the childhood, the mother will say, ye mera beta hai, badao ka ye banega. He will do such things. Ye beti hai, iski shaadi ho jayegi. So, but the partiality started from the beginning of home, from the mother, from the sister. So, we have to bring all these things out. See, we are living in India, which is, we can say, in the world, still we got the higher or the greater society, respectable society in culture, religion, faith in this country. The olden days, like Hume, Song, other person, they will come to India to learn these things. But today, we are going other country to earn money, but not learn those things. Still, in my country, my nation, the India, the foreigner coming to learn this culture. Maybe the Islam, maybe the Sikhism, maybe the Hinduism, or the Christianity. They all are given equal respect to the woman. They are not given definitions, no. The male is up or the female is down. No, never mentioned anywhere. Not where. Even in our holy book, it's mentioned very clearly, if the woman, she having menstrual cycle, those days also she can pray. There's no restriction at all. Because without that, the woman is incomplete. Nobody going to accept if the woman does not have proper reproductive system.
So those things still of our country. So again, I want to say, until we are not bringing education, and also the woman should feel stronger herself. Yes, I can do these things. It's not the question those days we have to fight on all these things. No. Only the education is there. Now we can do the good things. We are making bridge with the bricks. And bridge, we can make two person or two country or two nation or two sides, we can go and come and meet here. But we can make wall, we make separated. Same bricks. We are making bridge, we are making wall also. Wall makes separations, the bridge joined us. So only the education, not education about the society education, education about the own faith also.
Yeah, that is what, correct.
I want to mention here, now, the lady is going to the temple, the shlok read in Sanskrit. They not understand. Whatever he said, we are following blindly. Same in Islam. Whatever the priest in the mosque, they will say we are going to believe. Because we have not studied Arabic or Urdu, which language written there. Even now, I am saying about others, even the us also, Sikhs also in the Punjabi Gurmukhi, they are not studying. So I want to say the main things, our priest, they are misleading the society. The constitution is very far. The constitution we made in somewhere 1950, but the faith maybe 2,000 year old and 1,500 year old or 1,000 year old or even the 5,000 or more than that or beyond that. And the Sikhism just 500 year old. Constitution came in 1950 somewhere after 47, about 70 year ago. When we are not given equality or we are not given proper knowledge to the faith, which is the main important, the pillar.
Correct.
To live in this world, not only India. I'm not talking about the India, no. The faith have no border. Are you living in our country? Are you living in India? Are you living in Sri Lanka? Are you living in Canada, America? The faith have no limitation, have no border. Maybe the Hinduism or Islam or Sikh or Christianity, whatever they are. So when our holy book, all the holy book given equality to the woman, nowhere, I think, if you read the Sanskrit sloka or the Arabic or the Gurmukhi or Gurbani, nowhere mention the male or female are not equal. Because they address to the soul.
Mm-hmm.
They are equal. So, what I want to say there, we must teach proper faith to our own children. They can understand what the Holy Quran saying, what the Holy Granth saying, what the Holy Hindu Upanishad saying, and what the Holy Bible saying. So that's the first constitution for each and every parents and children and citizen.
Teach them their faith. That's the real focus.
Yes, until, see, one more thing is here. No faith saying the Islam is not good or Sikh is not good or Hindu is not good or Christian. No. Who created these things? Because we are uneducated. We doesn't know what faith saying. Whatever the Maulviji, what are the priests in the temple, or what in the Gurdwara they say, we are following this. And we are blind. Till date, we are not interested to have food from the Dalit woman. We are not interested. Because we got partiality. Maybe we are following so much things there. No, we are standing still there. Maybe we have a country got 17 years ago, independence, so we have got a lot of education. No. Our thinking, our genetic, our DNA still not changed. We require the more things here. Who going to change? Mother, sister, daughter, and wife. Because the male remain male, male become okay. Father. Mm-hmm.
Then I think it's time, if you say we are pointing everything to mother, sister, daughter, everything to us, probably when we are in need of your presence, probably all of you should group up and protect us. You are like silent spectators when any Nirbhaya case or whatever comes, mm-hmm. any case for that matter. I say, now the topic was about whether Indian women are liberalized or oppressed.
Subjugated.
Yeah. So I would want to stick to, I would not want to talk about the entire world, but I would want to talk only about my country. So where are you all when we need you the most? Why is that we have to come onto the roads and ask for justice when we are really kind of attacked? What are you all doing, the men folk? I mean, why don't you all go back, go to some other planets if you don't want to help us? So I feel, the society plays a lot of, a very huge role when it comes to whatever injustice is happening in the country. So you should not say it's a women's issue.
It's our issue.
No, it is your issue.
It's our issue.
Because we are your sisters, we are daughters, we are mothers.
Yes, same thing I'm saying. Same thing I'm saying. Jointly, not alone.
So,
not only.
Here I feel, instead of thinking about the Christianity, Islam, Hindutva, Sikhism and all that, we have, like you said, we have that strong DNA amongst us. It's a common DNA about our country, our Indian culture. It is the time that all the children, all the people understood our real culture of this country. Let us not ape the Western.
Yes.
Yeah, right. So, we need to protect each other. And we are like, you know, like man is a social being. So, it's time we all, in the name of caste, creed and religion, we should not move away from each other. It's time we all came together. Something happens to you, I should be with you. Something happens to me, you all should be with
us.
That's
humanity.
Yeah. That humanity, the spelling is now kind of misspelled. People don't know the spelling of humanity anymore. It's all about politics. It's all about groupism. It's all about religion. There's no humanity existing anymore. So it's time we wake up, at least for the next generation. Ours we have totally spoiled. The next generation has to be really kind of living amongst themselves with love and affection and oneness.
Okay. I have a very interesting question. You talked about Nirbhaya case.
Yeah.
And those rapists, they have been given capital punishment. What do you have to say about it as a woman?
As a woman, it was too late.
What do you expect out of it? What was expected early?
No, actually what I expected was even before when that episode happened, that unfortunate episode happened, I was called for a discussion on one TV channel. I said, you know, like those scoundrels have to be stoned to death immediately. Like they do in some...
Arab countries.
I mean, like, I'm not really sure.
That
has to happen.
Okay.
It should not be taking so long because we lose any kind of whatever faith we have in
the legal
system.
You say for a rapist, that kind of punishment should be given?
Of course, yes. Of course, yes.
Okay.
Any rapist for that matter.
Okay.
A man cannot force himself upon a lady, no matter whether he's a husband or any stranger. That is totally not accepted. And this law has to be made. I don't know when that is going to happen or whether it's going to happen at all. No, I don't see that. Again, because it's a male-dominated country, why aren't you all participating and insisting, sir? Why aren't you insisting that we need a law like
that? Kind.
Yes.
Okay.
You are keeping quiet because you are protecting your own clan.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
The Honorable Justice, Supreme Court of India, Justice Singh Thakur, he said same thing there. The woman's body is nothing but a temple. And we must respect that temple which created by the God in all manners.
So, she has put across a very strong point. As men, what are we doing? She wants the law where a person, a culprit or a rapist, he has been stoned to death if he is proven to have raped a woman. What do you have to say about that? Do we have to work for it?
That is her opinion, it's not my
opinion.
No,
you don't need to.
No, you don't need to work at all.
If you just come, stand, represent, that is good enough. There is no harm.
What I'm going to say there, see,
Why not you?
We have to bring education.
Okay.
And we become educated. We bring such a law,
okay,
such a strict law. First of all, the time continuation of the case,
okay,
it should be limit.
Limit, not for many years.
No, not for the 3 years, 4 years.
5 years.
Because what happened, the mostly cases happen, such rape cases, what cases, log kya kahenge. The many things will not do, the what people will go to say. Society mein sharam aati hai. Kis baat ki? When you lost everything there, how the case is prolonging long, the case becoming, the person who fighting becoming weak.
Yeah.
Another thing, bhai, what I say is, just as we expect a man's role in having a very kind of, you know, like peaceful atmosphere in the family or in the society, I feel even the women are equally responsible.
Correct.
The one side, women are being tortured, harassed and all that. Other side, there are a sect of women who are putting wrong notions into a man's
mind.
Thoughts.
Okay.
By, you know, like exposing themselves and doing all sorts of nasty things. Somewhere probably we need to curb those elements.
The advertisements that you see in the holding.
Exactly.
You know, so much of women's flesh is being sold to make some money.
Yeah, for a toilet, that thing, that commode advertisement, they want a lady. Why a man wouldn't use a commode? Razor, they want a lady to, be that model. It's when it's the man who is going to use the razor.
Yeah.
I mean, like, they are misusing a lady in all ways. I wouldn't blame those fellows who are misusing the ladies. I blame the ladies who are being,
why
you know, like,
forward?
Yes.
Why coming forward?
Why are they coming
so
forward?
So, I blame my clan there.
Okay.
That's one sect of clan. They are a minority, actually.
Okay.
Maybe 10 or 15% of them. But the effect what they are throwing upon us is really very, very dangerous.
The minority is causing more problems
yes.
to you.
They are causing a lot of problem. We
because,
don't...
Because your identity is being confused because of their actions.
Exactly. Now, even in the family,
yeah.
a lady, the man, like you said, a man toils from morning till evening. I have a friend's family. He works like a bull from morning till evening. And at the end of the month, he's only paid 1,000 rupees.
Mm.
His bank balance is 1,000 rupees. The remaining amount is taken away by the wife. And he is not supposed to question her.
If this is also happening.
Yes, it is happening. Men are being... I mean, are you aware? So many suicides, men are coming.
I need to have a topic. Are men liberated or subjugated?
Yeah, yes. And I always have a statement. All men are not bad. All women are not good.
Okay.
So somewhere we all need to kind of come together and address this issue.
Right.
To make this country, you know, like a wonderful country like it was before.
I have a question. Stimuli, pass on a stimuli. We talk about dowry, you know, dowry related cases. Almost 8,000 every year been recorded of dowry related deaths and many other cases so. Now, I want to understand the person who has been victimized is a woman and in many cases, the one who demands is also a woman.
It's a woman, yes.
It's the mother-in-law and the daughter-in-law friction that happens in our country.
Very true.
Now, whom are we going to blame for the dowry? Is it the woman or is it the man? It's another question I'm having.
Yeah, I know. Now, when you are taking the control, you know, like you want, you work, you have to, you, when you are working and taking care of the entire family, that's what you mentioned, you need that kind of authority in you. Now, I ask you, where do you keep that authority when these women are talking, when this wife of yours is demanding a dowry? From your would-be daughter-in-law.
True.
So what is that you are doing?
The role
where
of a man.
Yes. Where are you showing your authority here?
So man
only what comes onto your table or what happens in the bedroom is your authority? Or what your wife wears or your children wears or where she goes or where she doesn't go is your authority? Or are you not allowed to kind of take this authority when it comes to another girl? She's like a daughter to you, daughter-in-law.
True.
You want her to get money for you? Why are you keeping quiet?
Because I need status there. I want to see what Umar bhai and other people are going to say. How much I got dowry? What my daughter-in-law brought?
The status is blinding them.
Yes.
That's what he's saying. He's talking in favor of you.
Yeah. I mean, like I thought, you know, like he's giving
no,
him an answer.
No, he's talking in favor of you.
So, we are not innocent.
Right.
You are not innocent.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
It is all because of us.
So, education is important and an application of the education is also
Education
important.
Not only civil society, I'm saying.
And I would say, sir, on top of everything, a woman's role, I tell you, to treat another woman with a proper respect is totally upon her shoulders.
Yes, sorry, you can
Tell me. If the mother-in-law says she is going to be my daughter-in-law, she is a daughter-in-law.
Right.
I just want to accept her with open arms. There ends all these dowry cases.
Absolutely.
So, who would I blame here? Of course, I blame the man for keeping quiet.
Keeping quiet.
But I would want to blame my clan.
Absolutely.
I would want to be perfect before I blame you.
True, true, true.
So, I would say I would blame my clan.
Excellent. Now, we're going to end the program or we're coming to the closure. I just want to hear from each one of you. The best personality amongst the women folks, who comes to your mind now and why? I'll start with Dr. Harmindar Saab.
I can say sister.
Okay, and why?
Because she is doing good for society, what society needs.
Right.
Minimum she making awareness.
Right.
Maybe she unable to spend financial support.
Okay.
But she bringing awareness, which is very much important. And not one, I'm saying every woman, my sister, my mother, living in this country are very, very much important.
Yeah.
Only my request, they get educate themselves and give education to their children.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
How about
me,
you?
I don't have any role model.
Any personality that you can think of?
I take a little good qualities from every lady.
Mm-hmm.
And I have an imaginary lady in my mind who is kind of in a collective formation of all these good qualities amongst all the ladies. And I would always say a lady is a superpower. Any lady for that matter. So it's high time they all realized that and came forward and lived a wonderful life.
Okay, great. So it was a wonderful time that we have had, a lot of things to learn, a lot of things to agree upon, and a lot of things to differ upon. You know, that's how the whole debate is always, I mean, a dialogue or a discussion, where we learn from every discussion and we try to take the best out of every discussion. And having said that, I must say about the personality whom I revere a lot too, I mean, amongst the women folks, a lot of people, and list is too lengthy, but then at this moment in time, I would like to say Mary, the mother of Jesus. You know, Mary, the mother of Jesus. And in fact, in my college days, when I was just given the Quran, and I happened to read chapter number 19, is chapter Mary, the mother of Jesus. And that was one point where I told to myself, why is there the Quran talking about Mary, the mother of Jesus? What has that got to do? So we come to know that God says, we have chosen Mary above all the women of her times. So we revere her for the modesty, the thing that you are talking about. She was so modest that when an angel appears in front of her in the form of a human, in the form of a male, she says, please stay away from me. When no man has touched me, you're not supposed to be in the vicinity. Now, the womanhood, the modesty, and all these things, if you want to symbolize in one word, you can see Mary, the mother of Jesus. So with this note, we thank all of you, one and all, and thank the guests here who have been wonderful and who have shared a lot of thoughts. We'll be having such rendezvous time and again, and stay tuned and pass on all your positive comments in the upcoming, the discussion forums, wherever you happen to find and a possibility to share the comments, inshallah. So with this, we end the session. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you.